Now going to explain about the image enhancement. Image enhancement. So image enhancement, it is my topic in image processing, where we do discuss there about the properties of the image, how to enhance it. Enhancement in the sense improvement. Okay, improvement, how to improve the details of the image, how to improve the details of the image. Here we have to know what is an image and what it is made up of, and also how to improve the image. So image, I can say it is made of group of pixels. Group of pixels. So pixels, I am saying, so nowadays in this advanced technology we do speak about the pixel quality. If you take the mobile phone or the camera, digital camera, all those things we do speak about the pixel quality, means the image quality. Here I would like to explain about what is a pixel. So pixel, here I give an apt definition or a small definition for that. It is a picture element. It is a picture element. So here element. Element means here the detail of the picture. It is a detail of the picture. So again, I want to say what it has. The detail means it has one thing to be noted there. It has, okay, the intensity. Intensity. Now here we can know, or we can say, the only way to increase or to enhance or to improve the image quality is by increasing the intensity. In this image enhancement, we'll come back to our thing. Okay, image enhancement. So before going to the image enhancement, also another definition I would like to say, that is gray level. Gray level. Okay. So gray level of an image. So gray level of an image, here I can say it is a scale or a measure to find the intensity of an image. In brief, I'll explain the gray level as of such. Okay, so this is the scale, and here this is zero, and also this is the maximum intensity. This is zero and a maximum. Here I can say, I can consider as of such. So zero for black, and so this for white. So what I do, I take a pure white one, pure white, and I add a, okay, so this is pure white, and here I am adding a drop of, okay, so black spot or black ink. Okay, so it will be of some scale, so like this. Again I drop, so what I do, I add some more black content. Again it will be of something. Again some more black, some more, fully, now the solution, whatever it was white previously, now it is being totally changed to complete black. So black to white. Any image we take that falls in this category, from black to white. So this is called as the gray level of an image. Now in order to go for this, so in order to go for, okay, the thing, image enhancement, we can do in so two ways. So one is spatial domain, So one is spatial domain, and also another one is frequency domain. Here, spatial domain, as the name itself, it says that here we are dealing with the spatial, means space or XY coordinates of an image. Here we are dealing with pixels. We are dealing with pixels of an image. In other words, I can say we are improving the quality of the image by considering the pixels contained in an image. Next, coming to the frequency domain. Frequency domain, what we are doing there? We are applying the Fourier transform to an image. Applying Fourier transform, okay, to an image. Applying Fourier transform to an image. Now, we will go into the detail of spatial domain. Spatial domain, there are three techniques to improve the image. Okay, so here the one is point operation. Okay, and the second one is mask, and the third one is global operation. Okay, now here point operation. So prior to going to point operation, I will explain the representation of an image. The representation of an image, we do represent that in the form of a matrix. Okay, so representation of an image is being done in the form of a matrix. Okay, in point operation, what we are doing, okay, we are considering the image. So before enhancement, and so these are the two images, and they are being represented as the, okay, so matrix. So two images, and they are being represented as the matrix. The first technique, point operation, what I do, I consider one point there, and what I do, I enhance the same point here. So it is the input image fxy and output image gxy. So what I say, this is enhanced by point operation. Okay. Next one, the next technique, which is the mask operation. So the mask operation, here mask. Mask means, in the sense, here I am considering a, okay, so 3x3 matrix. So this is a mask. This mask, what I do? Here, I keep this mask on this image and I move on. Here, the center one. So this is called as center pixel, the center element in the matrix. It is called as center pixel. Okay. Now what I do here, as I said, this is the input image and this is the output image, and I take this mask and I keep it like this. Okay, fine, and I move on like this. So if suppose this is the mask, I keep it like this and I move on like this. Okay, so by doing so, what happens, the elements present in this input image are being multiplied with this, the elements present in this image are being multiplied with the elements present on the mask, and here we get the enhanced image. And the thirdly, global operation. So global operation, what we are doing on the whole, at once we are considering and we are doing the operation of all the pixels present in this image, and we are enhancing them as it is, pixel by pixel. So here we have seen three techniques, one as point operation, the mask operation, and the global operation. Now in this regard, I will explain one concept called as contrast stretching. Contrast stretching here I can explain as, here what I do, so this is R and this is equals to, so P of R, and here I am taking a factor M. So before going to that, I will explain what is the equation S is equals to P of R. S is equals to T of R, and here S is, the gray level of output image, and R, it is the gray level of input image, and so T, it is the transformation function. Now we are going to discuss about that by taking R, the gray level of input image, and also S for the gray level of output. And here, so I am taking an image, this is M. I am putting a factor M. And what I am doing, any image whatever we take, it should be having the black content as well as the white content. Black and white image. Now, here in this area, we have all the, so white content, and also in this area we have some of the, so black content starting from here and going there. Now to stretch, contrast stretching, so what I do, I consider the same plot, R, and S is equals to T of R, and this factor M, Now what I do, whatever is black, make it black, So this area, all the things on the left hand side, whatever is black, make it black, and it goes like this. And whatever is white, so make it white. In doing so, what happens? We are increasing the contrast. So here, black becomes blacker, white becomes whiter. In doing so, what is happening? We are stretching the contrast. By doing so, what I can say, the image is being enhanced. So in this enhancement technique, here we have seen the first one as spatial domain. We had seen about three techniques, one as the point, mask, and global. And also here in that regard, we had seen about the contrast stretching. In contrast stretching, only one thing, the concept involved there is, whatever is black, make it black, and whatever is white, make it white. So by doing so, we are operating on the pixels. We are doing the operations on the picture. Next, coming to the frequency domain, we do as sharpening and smoothing.